welcome to today's class on nature of fruits of quadratic equation. There are two major nature of fruits of quadratic equation. That is, real roots and no real roots. The no real roots can be called imaginary or complex roots. What are we talking about? Whenever you get b squared minus 4ac, which we call the discriminant of a quadratic equation, and it is greater than or equal to zero, you say it is real roots. You will get real roots. Then whenever you get b squared minus 4ac and it is less than zero, you say no real roots. Or you say imaginary roots. Or you say complex roots. Now, in today's class, we will see how to get these real roots, imaginary roots, complex roots, and so on. Let's see the question. Question number one says, for what range of values of f, for what range of values of k does the equation x squared plus k minus 3x plus k equal to 0 have distinct roots? Now, before we talk about distinct roots, these real roots are divided into two: equal roots and distant or different roots. Distant or different roots. Equal roots, distant or different roots, they make up real roots. That implies that whenever you say b squared minus 4ac greater than 0, it will be called real and different. The root will be real and different. Or you say real and distant. Then whenever b squared minus 4ac is equal to 0, we say it is real and equal. So the roots are real and equal. That is why we say these two make up the real roots. Now we see the question now. The question says, for what range of values of k does the equation x squared plus k minus 3x plus k equal to 0 have distinct roots? So what you do is that you write x squared plus k minus 3x plus k equal to 0. Compare it to the general equation of quadratic equation. Ax squared plus bx plus c equal to 0. That tells you that a will be equal to 1. Then b will be equal to k minus 3. Then c will be equal to k. Okay, now what you now do is you put these values, since they say distinct roots, this equation is for distinct roots, real and distant. Now you put this value into this equation, you will be having b squared means k minus 3. K minus 3 minus 4. Your a is 1, while your c is k. Then you say greater than 0. Then what you now do is that you expand k squared, 2 times k, 2k times minus 3, minus 6k, minus 4 times k, minus 4k, minus 6k. Let's expand again. K squared, 3 times, 2 times k, 2k, times minus 3, minus 6k, minus 3 squared will give you plus 9. Then minus 4 times k will give you minus 4k greater than 0. Collecting items, we have k squared minus 10k plus 9 greater than 0. If you factorize this, it will be giving you k minus 1 bracket 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 k minus 9 greater than 0. Now, see what you do. Put your number line to get the region that satisfies this equation. Here is negative infinity, and here is positive infinity. Then, if you make k minus 1 equal to 0, you'll be having k equal to 1. You locate it here. If you make k minus 9 equal to 0, you'll be having k equal to 9. You locate it here. Then pick any point here. You can see 0, negative number here. Pick 0, any number, pick any number here. Now when we pick 0 here, put it here. 0 minus 1, minus 1. 0 minus this, minus 9. Minus 1 times minus 9, 9. Is 9 greater than 0? You say yes, you mark good. You come again, you say if you carry 1, put here 1 minus 1, 1. 1 minus 1 is 0, please. 0 times 17 is 0. Is 0 greater than 0? You say no. 1 is not included. Pick anything here. You pick 2. Put 2 here. 2 minus 1, you'll be getting 1. 2 minus 9, minus 7. 1 times minus 7, you'll be getting minus 7. You add minus 7, are you greater than 0? You say no. It means this region is not included. Pick 9. 9 minus 9 is 0. 0 times everything here will be 0. You say 0. Is 0 greater than 0? You say no, because they are equal. Then you say that this 9 is not included. Then you come again, you pick any number here like 10. 10 minus 9 will give you 1. 10 minus 1 will give you 9. 9 times 1, 9. Is 9 greater than 0? You say yes. You mark here. Now from this number line we have, we can see that it is only this region that satisfies the equation, and only this region that satisfies the equation. You now say, therefore, since here is 1, and the region that satisfies the equation is numbers that are less than 1, you now say, first value of k will be less than 1. Now, since here is 9, and the number that are located here are numbers greater than 9, you say another value of k is greater than 9. That means only the numbers less than 1 and the numbers greater than 9 satisfy this equation. That will be the values of k for the question number 1. We go to question number 2. Then, to solve question number 2, we say, compare 4x squared plus tx plus 1 equal to 0 with ax squared plus bx plus c equal to 0. Now, you'll be having that your a will be equal to 4, then your b will be equal to t, and your c will be equal to 1. So what you do, is that since the question says, for what range of values of t does the equation this have complex root? Look at the formula you use. You put it here because this is where we have no real root, imaginary root, or complex root. That is for this equation. Your b is t. You say t square minus 4 bracket a is 4 and c is 1 less than 0. It will be giving you t square minus 16 less than 0. Now this simply means from difference of squares, we have t minus 4, t plus 4, less than 0. That is for difference, because 16 means 4 squared. So difference of square will give you t minus 4, t plus 4. Now what you now do now is you draw your number line. This is for negative number, this is for positive number. Now locate minus 4 and locate 4. Pick any number here. You pick minus 5. Minus 5 can be located here. Put it here. Minus 5 minus 4 will give you minus 9. Minus 5 plus 4 will give you minus 1. Then you now say minus 9 times minus 1, it will give you 9. Then you now say, is 9 less than 0? You say no. You say this region is not included. You pick minus 4. Put it here. Minus 4 plus 4 is 0. 0 times is 0. Is 0 less than 0? You say no, because they are equal. You say this region is not included. You now say again, pick any number here. 0 can be located here, because you have minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0. So 0 can be located here. Put 0 here. 0 minus 4, minus 4. 0 plus 4, 4. Minus 4 times 4, minus 16. Minus 16, are you less than 0? You say yes. It means this region is included. You pick 4, this one. Then you put 4 here. 4 minus 4, 0. 0 times everything here, 0. 0 less than 0, is it correct? No, because they are equal. You say no. Pick 5. 5 minus 4 will give you 1. 5 plus 4, 9. 1 times 5. 5 minus 4, 1. 5 plus 4, 9. 1 times 9 is 9. You ask 9, are you less than 0? You say no, because 9 is greater than 0. You say here is not included. The only region that satisfies the equation is only this region. And how do we represent it in a number line? You write t. Since this region is greater than minus 4 and less than 9, you say t is greater than minus 4 and less than 4. Since the region here is greater than minus 4 and less than 4, you say t is greater than minus 4. And so this is the region or the value of t that satisfies the equation. You go to the last question. For what range of values of k does the equation this have real roots? When you hear real roots simply mean both real and distant and real and equal. You remember this. This is where they have real roots. You now say, write the equation x squared plus k minus 3x plus k equal to 0. You compare it to ax squared plus bx plus c equal to 0. That tells you that a equal to 1, b equal to k minus 3, and c equal to k. Then you put it into the formula b squared minus 4ac greater than or equal to 0. Why are we using this formula? It is because the formula said that this formula or this discriminant b squared minus 4ac greater than or equal to 0, it is called the real root. It is formula used to get the real root. Now, you now say, okay, that implies that your b is k minus 3 all square. Then you say minus 4 bracket, your a is 1 and your c is k. You now say greater than or equal to 0. Now, the implication is that to expand this, k raised to the power of 2 minus 3 square, 2 times k, 2k times minus 3, minus 6 k. Then you now say minus 4 times k, minus 4k, greater than or equal to 0. You'll be having k squared minus 10k plus 9, greater than or equal to 0. Now what you now do is that if you factorize this, it will be giving you
K minus 1, K minus 9. Greater than or equal to 0. Now, if you make this equal to, if you make K minus 1 equal to 0, you'll be having K equal to 1. If you make K minus 9 equal to, if you will be having K equal to 9. You locate them on the number line. This positive infinity simply means to you whenever the positive number ends, and this negative infinity simply means to you whenever the negative numbers end. Pick any number here. Pick 0. Put it here. 0 minus this minus 1. 0 minus this minus 9. Minus 1 times minus 9 will give you 9. Is 9 greater than 0? Yes. So we mark here. So two things are what we'll be checking. Is it greater than 0? And is it equal to 0? Because we have two inequalities here. Now, you pick 1. Put 1. 1 minus 1, 0. 0 times everything here, 0. Is 0 equal to 0? You say yes. You mark this 1. You say that this 1 is also included. Now you pick any number here. You can pick 2. You put 2 here. 2 minus 1 will give you 1. 2 minus 9 will give you minus 7. Right? 1 times minus 7 will give you minus 7. Is minus 7 greater than or equal to 0? Not at all. Yes, because minus 7 is less than. So you say all the region here not included. Then you pick 9. 9 minus 9, 0. 0 times 17, 0. Is 0 equal to 0? You say yes. You pick here. Then you pick any number here, like 8. You can get 10 here. Because after 9, you get 10. This is positive numbers. Pick 10. 10 minus 9 will give you 1. 10 minus 1 will give you 9. 9, are you greater than 0? You said 9, are you greater than 0? You say yes. 9 is greater than 0. Now, what you now do is that only this region did not satisfy the equation. Now, to compute your answer, you say 1 are numbers less than 1, because this is negative numbers. So 1 are numbers less than 1 satisfy. So you say K less than or equal to 1. Or then 9 are numbers greater than 9 satisfy the equation. You say K greater than or equal to 9. So these are the values of K when you talk about real roots. Remember, it has equals to an inequality sign. Thank you for watching the video. Please try to turn on your notification button and click like and subscribe. See you next time. Please stay safe. See you next time.